described word. And this is an example. This is a very high-powered electron micrograph picture of the macrophage in blue, and you can see the green bacteria that has attached to it, all right? And what it's going to do, it's going to eat it, phagocytose it. So here's an example of the pink bacteria, and it's going to engulf it and bring it inside the cell in a little vesicle. And then in step four, the vesicle fuses with another vesicle called the lysosome, which has enzymes that are going to break down the bacteria. And then the bacteria gets digested, and then the waste and the debris are discarded. So that is phagocytosis. So let's say we get a cut in our skin, and we get bacteria coming in, all right? So one of the first cells that's going to be there is the macrophage. The macrophage lives in tissues. It doesn't travel. It stays in wherever it ends up going, it stays there. And it's first going to take this bacteria in red and engulf it. And it's going to sense that, hey, I have been infected by a bacteria. It's got molecules that will actually recognize bacteria. And it secretes proteins called cytokines. And these are messengers. And they help recruit other immune cells to the site of the infection. And they also cause the endothelial cells of the blood, of the lining of the blood vessels to open up. And you get fluid coming in. That causes the redness, swelling, and you get more immune cells there to fight the infection. All right? And normally, the infection is oftentimes contained, and it's no longer a problem. Okay? Now, that is what is called the innate immune system. Okay? Now, I'm going to go to the idea of the tattoo. All right? What happens when you inject this ink into the skin? What does the macrophage do? It eats it, okay? It eats it, but it cannot break it down. It cannot digest it. So what happens? Huh?
What is a waste product?
I can't hear you.
It's left as a waste product.
No.
It
stays there. It basically can't break it down into waste, so it stays there. So the reason the dye never leaves is it's sitting inside your macrophages, under your skin. Okay? So that's the idea of the tattoo. And actually, there's, yes?
Does it keep the macrophages from doing their other work?
Yes, it would, okay? But there are always new cells coming in. So it's not like it prevents you from making a response to bacteria, because there are other cells then that come in afterwards that can fight the infection. Yes?
Is that part of the reason why they use them instead of not being flush or warm with peroxide initially, because it does more damage than good? And also, the swell slightly in our reaction. Is that a reason for not applying ice to a wound that's trying to swell physiologically?
Yeah, well, the ice is also, that's right, physiologically, and also the heat that's generated during this. But it's a balance, okay? Because the inflammation and the swelling also does some damage. So we want to have a balance between mounting a good response but not having so much swelling, so much that it could then cause more damage. So it's a balance between these two things.
Your reaction is somewhat damaging, the natural reaction.
Absolutely. Inflammation is damaging, okay? And that's why you don't want chronic inflammation. Short-term inflammation can be healthy, a healthy response. But long-term chronic inflammation generally is not considered to be very good.
Well, the nice immediately is good.
All right, let me say this. I am not an MD.
No.
Okay? And so I don't want to make statements that relate to medical treatments. Okay? I'm trying to help you to understand why we might do things one way versus the other. But please, do not follow my instructions or my ideas necessarily. Yeah, really? Member at the Tilde Cafe, Sue Scientist, put ice on the wound. Yes?
How do the immune cells throw off of that ink?
Well, the macrophages sit there with the ink. Other cells will come in. Well, there's always new cells coming into the tissues. There just are. There's plenty of cells. I mean, when you think about all the different cells that we have here. Yes?
Yeah, I have a question. I have asthma. And you put me on prednisone so you don't get that long-term inflammation. What does prednisone do to this innate response to the macrophages? Is it slowing down?
Yeah. You know what? That's a clinical question. So I don't think I should be the one to answer that. Yeah, I think so. That's really a clinical question. Yes?
Does this ink cause inflammation, or do you know?
No.
If you have an infection, is that right?
Well,
it would be more difficult to heal.
Okay, the thing is this. If you inject a dirty needle into your skin, you're going to be bringing bacteria. Okay? So you can start causing an infection. All right. So now if the immune system is unable to completely, the innate response is unable to control and clear your infection, then you get what's called the adaptive immune response. And so what happens is there are sentinel cells that will migrate with bacterial material from the bacteria to the lymph node, all right? And in the lymph node are our adaptive immune cells, the T and B cells. They become activated, and then they will go out to the particular tissue to now fight in a more specific and a more effective way. So, you know your lymph nodes, when you get sick, sometimes they swell. And that's because you have an immune response going on, and your immune cells that are specific for the pathogen start growing and multiplying, so there's more of them. And that causes the swelling. And that whole system is what's called your lymphatic system. So I think most people know about the blood system, right? Everybody knows about their blood. But we also have what's called the lymphatic system. And the fluid that is in your tissues that will leak out from your capillaries, that fluid then goes into what's called your lymphatic system. And it passes through lymph nodes where it's filtered, and eventually it goes back into the blood up around the neck here. So that's the lymphatic system. Okay, so now we're going to shift to the topic for today. I wanted to mention the immune system, though, because one of the questions I'm going to ask is, does the immune system recognize our commensal bacteria? And how does it distinguish between harmful and beneficial bacteria? Okay, so we first talked about where they're living, and everybody really came up with the different locations for where they're living. And there are 70 different phyla classifications of bacteria. And it turns out that there are, in the colon, two prominent ones called the Firmicutes and the Bacteroides. And then we have about 10 to the 14th cells. We have 10 to the 12th on the skin, in the saliva, the esophagus, the stomach, the vagina. And as I said, the intestine is home to trillions of bacteria, And when you look at the bacteria, we see them in the stomach. Now, the stomach is very acidic, so not many bacteria like to grow there. But there are bacteria that grow.